Hello, my brothers and sisters. This is Minister Sonya Kyle. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Thank you for joining me today. I have a poem that I hope inspires someone, mind, body, and spirit today. Now, you know how we do it. We never get started without the reading of God's word. So let's get started. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous hand. That is Isaiah 41:10. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of this word. The name of this poem is called, He Specializes in That. A jack of all trades and a master of none is what the old folks used to say. I don't know about you, but I remember that saying from way back in the day. A jack of trades is when you dibble and dabble in a little of this or that among a small community or friends, but you really don't have anything that you specialize in. Now, a master is very precise in their forte or their job, but nobody has been as skilled or masterful as God. God can mend the broken and God can heal the lame. He knows all of our secrets and He knows all of our names. God gave His only Son, Jesus, so that we could be saved, because He knew good and well that we couldn't or wouldn't behave. Jesus died on the cross, but He rose again. Now allow me to break something down for you, my friends. You can be saved and forgiven for whatever, and that's a fact. Jesus can fix the problem, because He specializes in that. If you deal with present or past resentments, irritable moods, or discontentment, physical, mental, or spiritual fights, you know, the stuff that won't let us sleep at night. Things we say and do to other people that we know good and well is wrong. Perhaps you may still be holding it, or perhaps that person is gone. Maybe out of our lives or gone from this earth, but let me tell you something for what it's worth. You can be saved and forgiven for whatever, and that's a fact. Jesus can fix the problem because He specializes in that. I'm not going to be graphic, rude, or obscene. If our problem is lust, and y'all know what I mean, that can be dealt with. You do know God can see you, but that same loving God, He can free us from that too. So I'll say this now, and I'll leave that alone. The Bible explains right and wrong. Are you a grudge holder, refusing to forgive, with the "I'll never speak to them again as long as I live"? They betrayed me and they stabbed me in my back. But it's a good thing that God doesn't feel like that. God's not like man who only hears what we say in part. That's right, good people. God can read our hearts. So as far as refusing to forgive, you see, without forgiveness, where would we be? You can be saved and forgiven for whatever, and that's a fact. Jesus can fix the problem because He specializes in that. Marriage on the rocks? Mad at the kids, memories of the stuff that mama and daddy did, or what they didn't do, or who wasn't there, who slighted us, dogged us, who didn't treat us fair, who stayed in our lives and who left us behind, the deep dark things that we hide in our minds, the loss, the injuries, the guilt and the pain, the secret things that openly drive us insane. The things that we live with from day to day. I'm talking about the stuff that we can't drink or smoke away. We can't shop it away, eat it away, or gamble it away, my friends. So I ask you to let me say this again. You can be saved and forgiven for whatever, and that's a fact. Jesus can fix the problem because He specializes in that. If the enemy has been holding you hostage in your heart or your mind, let today be the day that you draw the line. Let your requests be made known to God. His office never closes and He's always on His job. So maybe tonight when you're alone with your own private thoughts, remember this poem and what was said and what was taught. You can be saved and forgiven for whatever, and that's a fact. Jesus can fix the problem because He specializes in that. I hope that I've helped someone to change how they behave, because we all in need of help. But the good thing is Jesus saves. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Now that's scripture. And if you're struggling with unforgiveness, I hope you get the picture. There is something after this life, my sisters and brothers. And if you don't want to miss out on it, because you refuse to forgive your mother, your father, your siblings, a family, or a friend. So I'm going to make sure that I say this line again. You can be saved and forgiven for whatever, and that's a fact. Jesus can fix the problem because he specializes in that. This is the end of the flow. And yeah, I said it. If we don't accept Christ, we will regret it. Much love to you all, and have a great day. Give your life to Jesus, and God will pave your way. If you have any questions on what this is about, ask the Lord to help you. God bless, and I'm out.